morning. The Lord spoke to a few people and said, "Prepare yourselves, for I am going to pour out my spirit in a mighty way throughout the world." We are in a new season. The lockdown did not happen accidentally. It made a way for God's children to prepare themselves, especially our hearts. Preparing means repenting of our sins, searching our hearts, uprooting that is not of Him, putting our lives right. He gave us this time for that reason and to seek His will. Holy Spirit is a very gentle person who dwells within us. As God's children, our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. It is the same Spirit who raised Jesus to life. When Jesus rose from the dead and walked on earth for 40 days and dwelt among His people, when it was time for Him to go to the Father, He said to His disciples, in the book of John 15, 26 and 27 says, "When the Counselor comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, He will testify about you, and you also must testify, for you have been with me from the beginning." This is the Helper, the Holy Spirit, that Jesus talks of. Acts 1:9 says, "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak out." So, as we prepare ourselves and wait for the day of Pentecost, God will honor us all with an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. He will empower us, equip us, and He will give the gift of the Holy Spirit accordingly. If I am to give an example from the Bible about a miracle performed by the Holy Spirit, it is in the book of Luke, chapter 7, 11 onwards. Jesus raises a widow's son. Soon afterwards, Jesus went to a town called Nain, and His disciples and a large crowd went along with Him. As He approached the town gate, a dead person was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a large crowd from the town was with her. When the Lord saw her, His heart went out to her, and He said, "Don't cry." Then He went up and touched the coffin, and those carrying it stood still. He said, "Young man, I say to you, get up." The dead man sat up and began to talk, and Jesus gave him back to the mother. They were all filled with awe and praised God. This is an instant where, in the olden days, when a person is widowed, there's no one to take care of them other than the children, especially the son. And in this case, she had only one child and a son who had just died. So Jesus' compassionate heart goes towards this woman and He raises her back to life. So this is one miracle that Jesus performed on earth that is recorded in the Bible. And Jesus is equipping us also for the Great Commission as spoken of in the book of Matthew, chapter 28. He wants us to speak and reach out to the lost souls. So, family, get ready for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, and let's pray that there'll be a mighty outbreak as we participate in this joint service this Sunday. All the pastors, all the services get together and pray and worship God, that heaven will come down and we will see a mighty breakthrough and a revival will come out of it. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.